What's up, guys? I got about as far as I can get on the 55-56 for now. Until I get at least some freaking sunshine. So I'm getting started on the 69 fetters for now. So far, it's going pretty good. I'll show you what I'm up to next. This one here is held on by two screws here. One here. And this one just screws into this. I mean, there's not really much holding it in. But it looks like there's two bolts right here. One here and one here. I already got the fan blade loose. So we'll see. Let's see what happens. This fan motor is not seized completely, but it's pretty stiff, so it's gonna take some work. Look at the size of that evaporator, man. This thing is rated at 14,000 BTUs, but I'm pretty sure it's gonna be a conservative rating. I have no reason to believe this ain't gonna do the whole apartment with its eyes closed, no problem. I'm gonna draw a wiring diagram next before I start ripping it apart too much. So the chassis is in decent shape. Look here, what we got here? Yeah, 1969. That looks like, what does it have here? Why is this thing, oh, that's because I'm out of zoom. Alright. So G means General Electric fan motor. One dot means, if I recall correctly, means one shift, first shift. H means an H, would that be? 8, so that's August 13th, 1969. What is the date that this Tecumseh B-Series was born? So I'd say this is either a late 1969 model or a 1970 model. That was made, this thing was made 4 months after my mom was born.
Well, just shy of, just shy of 4 months.
3 months and almost four. Anyway, it don't matter. So I want to pull this out, get it unwired, and pull this all out because I want to do the base pan the best I can. I'm not going to pull the cooling system out because realistically, I just don't have the help or the resources right now. And B series are very hard to get balanced again. So we're just going to kind of let it go. It's in good shape. I want to put oil-based primer down the best I can. I'm going to get it apart, as much of it apart as I can. And we're gonna go from there, kind of like I did for the 55-56. And like I said, there was very, very, very little that I wasn't able to do. And it was nothing crucial. So get this Tecumseh B-Series compressor, paint it back up, ready to go. Get a wiring diagram drawn up. Start gutting it, sanding it down, painting everything. And then hopefully I can reassemble them both the same day. The reason I'm stuck at a standstill right now on a 55-56 model is because my crimp kit, my electrical connections, and all the wire I ordered didn't come in yet. Oh, check this out. Tell me that don't look freaking good. I gotta try to get better with the paint marker. I tried it, and it just didn't want to stick. It looked like it was trying to run off a little bit. But yeah, this thing's ready to go back together. I am very happy with the way everything turned out on it. So the paint's still slightly stiff yet on it. Not wet by any means, but like I said, this just looks awesome. I just gotta get everything put back together on it slowly but surely. Once the wiring comes in, I'll be able to get the crimps on, rewire the whole entire thing. I'm gonna rewire this whole entire thing too. Like I said, this is my new big thing, being the problems I had with my bedroom fetters. This thing actually freed up decently. And you can see it does have a little bit of a free spin. Now, not much of one, but it's definitely a major improvement over what it was. And it runs quiet and cool, so that's all I care about. This one here is going to need some help too. But like I said, I am very confident that when this is all said and done, I'm going to have two very good running and very reliable air conditioners to put in the second floor apartment building. And like I said, you'll be able to see both of these from the main road at Route 61 and 209 in Pottsville. You'll be able to look over. If you're at the red light going up 61 North, it'll be to your right on the second floor of the yellow building. So if you're ever out that way and want to take a look, go for it. That's where they're going to be. Can't miss them. Anyway, guys, I'll get back with you, you know, as I have updates ready. And hopefully, if I play my cards right and get all this put back together over the next couple days when I have off, and I'm planning on installing both of these on Tuesdays in a week from yesterday. So we'll see. It's going to be close. I might not be able to get everything done, but I'm going to try my damnedest. So that being said, peace out. Thank you for watching, and stay tuned.